This just in, breaking news. There appears to be a wild animal or a killer on the loose. We seem to have an eyewitness. We're going to him live. Now, what did you see, fella?
It was gaunt, to the point of emaciation. Its desiccated skin pulled so tightly over its bones. Seems like its bones were pushing out of its skin. Its complexion, the ash gray of death. And its eyes pushed back deep into its sockets. It looked like it recently pulled itself from the grave. What lips it had were tattered and bloody, unclean and suffering from superations of the flesh. It also gave off a strange, eerie odor of decay and decomposition, of death and corruption.
Well, now, fella, that's something. You should probably go, seek some help.
I know what I saw.
In the folklore of Plains and First Nations people, the Wendigo was once a legendary hunter who turned to cannibalism and became an insatiable monster. As the story goes, the Wendigo was once a lost hunter. During a brutally cold winter, this man's intense hunger drove him to cannibalism. After feasting on another human's flesh, he transformed into a crazed man-beast, roaming the forest in search of more people to eat. The story of the Wendigo comes from Algonquin Native American folklore, and the exact details vary depending on who you ask. Some people who have claimed to encounter the beast say it's more of a relative of Bigfoot. But other reports compare the Wendigo to the werewolf instead. Since the Wendigo is said to be a cold-weathered creature, most sightings have been reported in Canada, as well as colder states of the United States, like Minnesota or New York. At the turn of the 20th century, the Algonquin tribes blamed many unsolved disappearances of people on Wendigo attacks. A Wendigo is an insatiable predator. It is definitely not the largest or the most muscular beast out there, though some reports say that it is almost 15 feet tall. Its body is often described as emaciated. Perhaps this can be attributed to the notion that it is never satisfied with its cannibalistic urges. Obsessed with hunting for new victims, he is forever hungry until he's eating another person. According to Legends of the Nahanni Valley, a native author once described the Wendigo in his masterworks. According to ethnohistorian Nathan Carlson, it also been said that the Wendigo has large, sharp claws and massive eyes like an owl. However, some other people simply describe the Wendigo as a skeleton-like figure with ash-toned skin. But no matter which version sounds the most plausible, this is obviously not a creature you'd want to run into on a hike. Different versions of the Wendigo legend say different things about his speed and agility. Some claimed it is unusually fast and can endure walking for long periods of time, even in harsh winter conditions. Others say he walks more of a haggard manner, as if he's falling apart. But speed wouldn't be a necessary skill for a monster of this nature. Unlike other terrifying carnivores, the Wendigo doesn't rely on pursuing his prey in order to capture and eat it. Rather, one of his creepiest traits is their ability to mimic human voices. It uses the skill to lure people in and draw them away from civilization. Once they're isolated in the desolate depths of the wilderness, he attacks them and feasts on them. The Algonquin people say that during the turn of the 20th century, a large number of their people went missing. The tribes attributed many of the mysterious disappearances to the Wendigo, thus calling him the spirit of lonely places. Although a rough translation of the Wendigo is the evil spirit that devours mankind, this translation is related to yet another version of the Wendigo that has the power to curse humans by possessing them. Once he has infiltrated their mind, he can turn them into Wendigos as well, instilling upon them a similar lust for human flesh. One of the most infamous cases in the story of Swift Runner, a Native American who murdered and ate his whole family during the winter of 1879. According to Animal Planet, Swift Runner claimed to be possessed by a Wendigo spirit at the time of the murders. Still, he was hanged for his crimes. Rightfully so. Frighteningly enough, there was quite a few other stories about these spirits supposedly possessing people in communities stretching from northern Quebec to the Rocky Mountains. Many of these reports were shockingly similar to the Swift Runner case. Now, whether you believe the Wendigo lurks in the woods at night or not, this is not just another boogeyman story meant to scare people for no reason. It has historical significance in many indigenous communities. The legend of the Wendigo has long been associated with real-life problems like insatiable greed, selfishness, and violence. It also linked to many cultural taboos against these negative actions and behaviors. Basically, the word Wendigo can also function as a symbol for gluttony and image of excess, as Basil Johnston has written, and the idea of turning Wendigo is a very real possibility when the world refers to self-destruction rather than literally becoming a monster in the forest. But ironically enough, these stories might actually represent the indigenous people's response to the horrific violence unleashed on them by non-native people. In fact, many anthropologists believe that the concept of the Wendigo only developed after the native people had contact with the Europeans. Rewriting Apocalypse adds that some modern-day confusion about the Wendigo may have to do with certain terms getting lost in translation. One well-known mistake was traced to the compiler of the dictionary, who entered the information regarding the word Wendigo and substituted the word ghoul for an appropriate word, fool. He thought the native people meant ghoul. But what about all those scary Wendigo stories that supposedly affected real people? Some anthropologists also argue that Wendigo stories, especially involving Wendigo accusations, are linked to the stress within the Native American communities. The local tension leading up to such accusations may even be compared to the fear that preceded the Salem witch trials. However, in the case of the Native American communities, most of the stress was due to the dwindling amount of resources, not to mention the extermination of food in the area. Under those circumstances, who could blame them for having a fear of starvation? Just about the only thing scarier might be what one of them would do if the starvation became too much to handle. The vast majority of supposed Wendigo sightings happened between the 1800s and 1920s. Few reports of the creature have surfaced since then. But every so often, an alleged sighting emerges. Most recently, in 2019, mysterious howls in the Canadian wilderness led some to question whether they were caused by an infamous man-beast. One hiker who was present said, "I've heard many different animals in the wild, but nothing like this." Much like other legendary beasts, the Wendigo remains a fixture in pop culture and modern times. The creature has been referenced and sometimes even depicted in a variety of hit television shows, including Supernatural, Grimm, and Charmed. Interestingly enough, there are even a couple of lakes today named after the beast, including a lake Wendigo in Minnesota and Wendigo Lake in Wisconsin. But those who believed in a physical Wendigo think he might still be out there in the woods, and underneath that terrifying flesh-eating demon, there might still be a human man who was once just a hungry hunter.